In paranormal investigation, it's imperative to ask questions to get all the facts before you make an educated decision. Locations where crimes are committed, where somebody might have been murdered, have a strong connection with the victim. And that's what we're looking for today.
The house has obviously changed a lot in 40 years since Ferdinand Shipman lived here with his father. Residual energy becomes recorded in the floorboards and in the walls. This is a good capacitor for psychic energy, for paranormal activity.
As night falls, Patrick sets up his equipment at the spot where the bludgeoned bodies of Vernon Shipman, Charles Glass, and Louise Shoemate were discovered nearly 40 years ago.
Lights are positioned, the cameras are in place, the sensors are properly positioned. I think we're ready to begin.
In the course of doing our investigative work from a scientific perspective, very seldom are we actually looking for a physical manifestation of a ghost. That's usually a pretty rare occurrence. What we're looking for is an inference that a ghost may be present. How do they disrupt the environmental variables? That's a strong indicator that there might be a presence there, even though we can't directly observe it with our eyes.
John and Carla, we're in North Dakota today, investigating the murder of a 19-year-old Native American man named Russell Turcotte. I'm looking for any paranormal activity in the still photos that I take today. Infrared frequencies of light have long been associated with capturing spiritual energy. This digital camera has been professionally modified, and I'm going to be using it tonight during our investigation to try and capture paranormal activity. What I'm looking for now is something we refer to as EVP, or electronic voice phenomena.
EVP is an acronym. It stands for electronic voice phenomena. And quite simply, these are voices and sounds that, again, are not audible to the unaided ear at the time the recording is made. They're only audible at the time the recording is played back. And in my personal opinion, this is some of the most compelling evidence that we have of the existence of ghosts.
I may have picked up something already.
All right.
Patrick studies the afternoon's recordings for electronic voice phenomena.
I think I have a voice saying, Patrick. Very loud. That would be a Class A EVP. It's a little eerie. This one really makes my skin crawl.